morning, everyone. I am going to lead us through a 60-minute class that is focused on our hamstrings. As always, feel free to add things in if you want something more intense. You can skip and modify if you want less, and then customize everything to your body and what you need today. And I hope this will bring you some grounding. Yeah. We're going to start in Shavasana on the back body, so go ahead and lie back and get comfortable. And just deciding what shape feels best for your body in this moment. So you take a moment to settle in. Feel the weight of your muscles and bones drop into the support below. Begin to shift your focus to the rise of your inhale and the fall of your exhale. As you connect to your body and breath here, maybe also begin to connect to that deeper purpose for being on your yoga mat today. Let this purpose form an intention for your flow. And to offer your movements that deeper meaning. And to remind you that your practice is so much more than shapes. Allow your inhales to get a little bit fuller now. Feel your exhales go really smooth and steady as they release out. So each breath in deepens and expands nice and wide. Every exhale is a gentle release, an invitation to let go. As you continue to breathe here, feel yourself here, your body, your heart, your mind, your breath, all in one location, present to your practice and all its potential. Take a deep breath in through your nose. An open mouth exhale, release. And two more like that. Big breath in through your nose. Open mouth exhale, let go. One more time, big breath in, fill all the way to the top. Open mouth, exhale, release. Just allow your lips to seal, breathe in and out of your nose. Your oceanic Ujjayi Pranayama. Just spread your fingers and your toes wide. We circle with your ankles and your wrists. With a deep breath in, reach your hands up and overhead, take a full body stretch. And then on your exhale, bring both knees into your chest. You start with a little rock from side to side. And then take both hands to your reach and extend your left leg out and down. So you draw your right thigh in close, breathe into the connection on your belly, okay, between your thigh and your torso. And with your exhale, begin to twist, let your right leg tip all the way across your body towards the left. Just take two cycles of breath here. Thank you. after your second breath, go ahead and come back through center. Keep your right knee bent and land your right foot to the earth. Now use your core to lift your left leg up to the sky. Now reach behind your left leg. Any bit of softness through your knee and start to open through your hamstring, calf, and ankle. As you'll flex your left heel tall, maybe point through your toes, maybe circle through your left ankle. Head, shoulders, hips all nice and heavy on the earth. Begin to flex your left heel up. Okay, gently encourage your leg towards your body a little bit closer. Then breathe right into your hamstring. Start to flex your left heel high. We're going to extend our right leg forward to a hover. If that's too much for your body, feel free to keep your right knee bridged on the earth. And then we'll take our hands behind our head here. And elbows go wide, belly strong. And on your in-breath, start to lower your left leg. Maybe left heel comes to tap your right toes. On your exhale, lift your left leg, add a twist, cross your right elbow towards your left thigh. And then same thing, inhale, left leg lowers, head and shoulders can be lifted between sets, and then exhale to lift and twist. Good, inhale, lower and open. And exhale, left leg lifts as you twist. Good, inhale, lower, open, maybe reach your right hand towards the wall behind you. Exhale, lift your left leg, maybe reach your right hand up and across towards the outside of your left ankle. And two more here, inhale, left leg lowers, right hand reaches back. Exhale, left leg high, reach your right hand up and over. And one more time, inhale, expand. From your strong core, exhale, lift and reach. And then release, relax, bring both knees to your chest. Take a big breath in. And exhale out. And land your feet to the earth for a bridge pose. As you root down with your feet, begin to lift your pelvis. With your heels stacked right below your knees, feet are about hips distance apart. Really push down through your feet. And your big toes in particular. Feel your inner thighs, core strong. Send your tailbone gently forward. Put your heels gently towards the back of your heart so you feel your hamstrings engage. And send some weight over to your right foot. Lift your left leg up to the sky, the same leg that we already opened. Yeah. Push up through your left heel and down through your right. Maybe press your triceps into the earth to help with the lift of your pelvis. A core keeps your hip points square. And on your in-breath, lower your left leg halfway down. Push energy forward through your left heel. Exhale, lift your left leg up to the sky. Two more like that. And inhale to lower your left leg halfway down. Exhale, push and lift your left leg to the sky. And one more time here. Inhale, we lower halfway. Exhale, lift your left leg tall. Then figure four, your left ankle on your right thigh. And release your pelvis to the earth. Right foot can stay grounded or bring that whole figure forward to your body and maybe rock a little side to side. Okay, we'll head to window moving pose, second side. So extend your right leg long. Bring your left knee to your left shoulder, left shin and thigh bone parallel to your torso. And move a breath to your belly. Then exhale to twist, left leg will fall across you to the right. And just take two cycles of breath here. And just like the first side, when you come back to center, your left knee stays bent and your left foot down. Maybe bring your hips to square and then send your right leg to the sky from the strength of your core. Press your left foot to float your right leg up to the ceiling. reach your hands behind your right leg and start to open your hamstring, calf, and ankle. Your shoulder blades slide down out of your ears so there's more space around your neck. And then reach your right heel high. Encourage your right leg towards you. Feel the back of your right leg open. And from here, start to send your left leg forward to the hover, unless you're keeping your left leg in a bridge position. And then take your hands to interlace behind your head. Follow your in-breath to lower your right heel towards your left toes. Your belly to spine. On your exhale, lift your right leg and twist your left elbow across. And then inhale to lower and open. Exhale, right leg lifts, left elbow crosses. And one more like this. Inhale, lower, open. Exhale, lift and twist. This time as you lower, maybe reach your left hand towards the back of the room. Right hand supports your head. Exhale, right leg rises, reach up and across. And two more like that. Inhale, lower and open. And exhale, reach up and across. Last one here, breath in to expand. Exhale, right leg rises, stretch up and over. And release, relax through center. Give yourself a breath in. Land your feet as you breathe out, setting up for your bridge pose. Right, press it down into the earth. Elevate your pelvis to the sky. Feel your back and front body strong. Feel your ujjayi breath, right, that balance to the effort. When you're ready, send some weight to your left foot. Re-engage through your core, push to your arms, and lift your right leg to the sky. Both heels are active. Belly is strong, breath flowing. Your inhale to lower your right leg halfway down. Exhale, push through your left foot, lift through your right. Now use your breath, inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. One more time here, breath in to lower. Here, exhale to lift. And then figure four, right ankle and left thigh, and drop your pelvis to the earth. Now just slide on the depth of your figure four, and just take a breath to either be in movement or stillness. Begin to unwind your legs, bring your knees into your chest. Put your rock and roll forward and back. And find your way to your tabletop pose, all fours. With your shoulders right above your wrists, your hips right above your knees. On your next breath in, inhale to your cow shape. Begin to lift your heart and lift your tail. Your exhale guides you to cat round through your spine. And take two more like that. Breath in to open your front leg. Exhale, feel your shoulder blades spread apart. Push the earth away. One more time here. Inhale, pull your heart forward. And exhale, right, tuck in the earth side. And bend a long and neutral spine. And tuck your toes underneath. Root your hands as you pull your belly in and then hover your knees like an inch or two above the earth. Feel your ujjayi breath as you push the earth away. And press the back of your skull gently to the sky. Drive down through your toes so you feel your thighs strong. Hug your arms to center, keep a block between them. And take one more breath in. And exhale, downward facing dog, send your hips up and back. Just take a moment here, maybe pedal with your feet. You can adjust your stance as much as you need. And as you're ready, start to just wander forward, forward fold at the top of your mat. Take your time to get there. And allow your hamstrings to open along the way. And let your knees bend when you arrive. Sway a little bit forward and back if you'd like to. You can keep softness here through your knees in order to create length in your spine. So think about your hip creases pulling up and back. The weight of your head pulls extension through your torso. And keep some softness in your knees. Next breath in, take a halfway lift. Use your inhale to lengthen out. And your exhale, forward fold release. Breathe in, rise all the way up. Urdhva Hastasana, both hands go high. And exhale, hands to heart center. And you take a big breath in, honoring your body. And open mouth, exhale, release. Next breath in, reach high to the sky, Urdhva Hastasana. And your exhale, fold to the earth, soften your knees and hinge forward from your hips. Inhale to lift up halfway. And exhale to your high plank, plant your hands, take a mindful step back. And as you hold here, push the earth away. Turn your navel to your spine and your tailbone to your heels. And isometrically drag the heels of your hands to your toes and your heart slightly forward. And head is in line with your spine, so back of your skull elevated. Breathe your Ujjayi Pranayama. And inhale, shift forward to your tippy toes. Exhale, lower all the way down to the earth. Untuck your toes when you arrive. Low cobra, press down with your toenails. Inhale to lift your heart. And your exhale, gently release. And inhale, low cobra. Option to hover your hands as you rise up. Really press your toes so your thighs engage. And exhale to release. And last one here, inhale, low cobra. Maybe you hover your hands, maybe you reach your hands forward. And feel your upper back engage a little bit more. One more breath in. And release, hands go by your low ribs with your breath out. Tuck your toes underneath. Knees up or knees down for support. Push into your hands, strong through your belly, high plank pose. And one breath in. Down dog with your exhale out. And fingers nice and wide. Inhale to rise your heels high. Exhale, bend your knees and then step or hop to the top, forward fold. When you arrive, let your knees stay soft. Take a halfway lift, deep breath in. And exhale, forward fold, release. Inhale, rise to stand. Exhale, rub your hands at your heart. And breathe in, reach top. Exhale, fold you back to the earth. Take a halfway lift, find extension. Exhale takes you to high plank pose, mindful step back. In breath, shift forward. Lower halfway or all the way. Open your heart up dog or cobra this time. A deep breath in, thighs and core strong, heart open. Down dog is your exhale, pike your pelvis to the sky. And we'll take one more sunny. When you're ready, inhale your heels up high. Exhale, bend your knees, travel to the top, forward fold. Halfway lift with your inhale. And fold on your exhale. And rise to stand, big breath in. Hands at heart center, breath out. Inhale, grow tall. And exhale, forward fold release. Breathe in, lift halfway. And exhale, vinyasa or down dog. So step back or flow back. Just choosing the combination of shapes that feels good for your body. As we meet in down dog, just take a big breath through your nose. Maybe an open mouth exhale, let it go. And inhale your right leg to the sky, three-legged dog. With an exhale, go ahead and bend your knee, open your hip. Push energy through your hands, feel your left hip crease pull up and back, and draw your belly in. Right glute strong, lift your right knee with your right seat strength. Then inhale, three-legged dog, re-extend. Exhale your knee to your nose, shift forward. Three-legged dog, breath in, pulls your right leg up and back. And step your right foot to the top of your mat, low lunge. Sink your left knee to hover, cow lunge, heart reaches forward and through, breath in. And on your exhale, lengthen your legs to your cat lunge, your hamstring stretch. Okay, two more like that. Inhale, bend through your knees, open through your heart. And exhale, lengthen through your legs. And one more time here. Inhale, shift forward, press back through your left heel. And exhale, tailbone pulls up and back. Bend into your right knee. And then push down through your right foot. Pull yourself to a gentle standing split so left leg finds the sky. You can bend your right knee as much as you need to. Let the weight of your head fall heavy. Be relaxed, your jaw. Okay, for today, allow your hips to be square. So if I open my hips, I can find a lot more height. But we want to find our hips square. Okay, nice and stable through our pelvis. Release your left foot to the earth for chair pose. Send your hips back. And feel your hip creases pull back as you push through your heels and rise up tall. And take an inhale here. On your exhale, knit your front ribs together. Keep that and then try to lift your hands with your upper back straight, breath in. And forward fold on your breath out. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, vinyasa or a down dog. So again, your customized transition, step back or flow back. And from your downward facing dog, inhale your left leg to the sky. Exhale, knee to nose, shift forward. Three-legged dog, big breath in. Left foot to the top, your breath out. When you're ready to hover, cow lunge. Find length through both legs, your cat lunge. And two more here, inhale shifts you forward. Your exhale is gonna pull you back, tailbone to the sky. One more like a wave. Inhale forward to your cow lunge. And exhale back to your cat lunge. And bend into your left knee. Shift forward, standing splits right leg to the sky. And don't worry about how high your right leg is. Just allow your head to fall heavy. Feel the openness to the back of your left leg. If you're doing this in the morning like I am, you're probably a little bit tighter, a little bit stickier through the backs of your legs. And one more breath here. We'll step into chair pose, land your right foot to the earth. And send your hips back, inhale, lift your heart and hands up high. And exhale, push your heels into the earth, let your glutes engage more. Even lower, lengthen your spine as you breathe in. Upper back strong, front body strong, forward fold, breath out. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale your way to downward facing dog. So again, this is your transition to take exactly what you need. Big breath in through your nose. Exhale, let it go. Inhale your right leg to the sky. And exhale, knee to nose, shift forward. Three-legged dog, inhale to lift. Exhale, right knee, right tricep, heart goes straight forward. Three-legged dog, breath in. Right knee to your left tricep, breath out. Three-legged dog, we lift. And exhale, step your right foot forward to the top. One time cat lunge, dip your left knee low. One time cat lunge, lengthen out your legs. Bend into your right knee, standing splits. Left leg to the sky, your inhale to lift. This time Shiva squat, exhale, bend and tap your left knee towards your right calf. Lift your heart at the bottom. Push through your right foot, inhale, re-extend standing split. The two more here, exhale, bend to tap. Inhale, push down to re-extend. Last time here, exhale, bend and tap. Inhale, standing splits. Chair pose, find your seat. Inhale to lift your heart and hands. Exhale, airplane your arms. Move your weight to your left foot and flamingo your right heel up in it. Okay. Feel your hip creases pull back in your flamingo, extend your crown. Root down and rise up tall with your right leg. And reach tall to the ceiling, take a moment to find your breath. From here, figure four, flex and sit, maybe hands find heart center. Active right ankle, feel the openness to your right hip. You can even use your hands to feel where your pelvis is in space. Right obliques contracted. Energy around your heart, push your hands together. We're gonna fly into an airplane pose next, so go ahead and rise up. Unhook your right heel and then really slowly push through your left leg to expand out. Press down through your hands to the back of your skull, lift gently to the sky. You take one more breath in. Crescent lunge, your right toes release. On an inhale, send your hands to the ceiling. And exhale, airplane your arms, heart leans forward, fingertips reach back. Reaching crescent, extend your hands out in line with your spine with your inhale. And then plug your shoulders into your torso on your exhale. One more breath in. Hands to the earth, breath out. You twist your left hand to the sky, heart rotates open. And then wrap your left sitting bone in, press strong through your right toes, right quad, lights up. Okay, feel your sternum stretch forward, shoulder blades scooch your heart forward, another inhale here. And exhale, rise your left hand to the earth. And push the earth away, three-legged dog, lift your left leg to the sky. On your exhale, bring your knee into your nose. Three-legged dog, big breath in. Left knee, left tricep, breath out. Three-legged dog, inhale to lift. Exhale to your right tricep, sweep underneath your heart, shoulders stay square. And three-legged dog, inhale to rise. Left foot to the top, land it light. Cat lunge, sink your right knee low. And your cat lunge, lengthen your legs out. Bend into your left knee. Standing split, sweep your right leg to the sky. Then your in-breath at the top. Shiva squat, bend and tap. Good. Drive through your left heel, re-extend standing splits. Shiva squat, bend and tap. Good. One more time, push and extend. Standing splits to Shiva squat, get low. Heart goes high. Good. Root to reach. Chair pose, stand into your seat. Now press through your heels, inhale lifts you tall. Exhale, airplane your arms. You transfer the weight to our right foot. Flamingo your left heel up. Feel the hamstring action on your left leg. Then push down, grow tall with your left leg. A moment of breath. And we'll shift to figure four. Left ankle on right thigh, hands arrive to heart center. Think about pushing down through your right foot to pulling through your center belly. Again, try to lengthen your spine and keep the energy around your heart as you push your hands together. When you're ready to fly, you're going to rise up just enough to unhook your left ankle. Stay close to start and then push into your airplane pose. Give yourself a breath in. Really slow descent, crescent lunge, left toe step back. Inhale your hands up to the sky. And on your exhale, airplane your arms, lean forward. Reaching crescent breath in to extend. Your exhale, navel to spine, shoulder blades plug in. One more breath in, push into your strong feet. On your exhale, release your hands to the earth. And twist your right hand to the sky, rotate around. Let your right shoulder lean back, let your ears lean back. And hug an imaginary block between your thighs. One more breath in. And right hand lowers down. Push the earth away, lift your right leg to the sky, three-legged dog on your inhale. Knee to nose is your exhale. One-legged plank, push your right foot back, breath in. You're gonna right knee, right tricep, exhale. Inhale, one-legged plank. Exhale, right knee, left tricep. Three-legged dog, right leg to the sky. Big step forward, right foot to the top. Move your weight to your right foot. Standing splits, lift your left leg to the sky. And Shiva squat, bend and tap. And standing switch, push to extend. Shiva squat, bend and tap. Maybe get light through your fingers or even hover your hands to heart. Standing splits, extend. Last time here, Shiva squat and pause. Bring your hands to heart center. And peel your heart away from your right thigh. We're gonna step back into a crescent lunge. Left toes go all the way back. Push into your feet, inhale, lift it tall. Exhale, airplane arms. Your breath into reaching crescent. Exhale, spin your left heel down to warrior two. Grow tall and take a moment here, find your feet. You need to move or adjust your stance, you can. Okay. Long through your spine, with your in-breath, reverse your warrior, right hand goes high. And exhale, side angle, lean in and down. Pause here, roll your left shoulder back. Feel a long line of energy through your body from your left hand towards your right heel, from your crown to your left heel. And then reach your left hand overhead, your extended side angle, and push down through your left palm to unload some of the weight from your right forearm. Anchor down to the outside edge of your left foot, light through your left arch, and take one more breath in. And exhale, we're going to circle sweep to a wide-legged forward fold. All 10 toes turn to the long edge of your mat. And you take three slow breaths. Next breath in, take a halfway lift. On your exhale, turn to the left, low lunge to the back of your mat, all 10 toes rotate. And from here, send your weight to your left foot, chair pose, step your right foot forward to a seat. Your inhale to lift your heart and hands up high. Exhale, airplane arms. And on an inhale, bring your hands up to your chair pose again. Exhale, your hands to heart center. Move your weight to your left foot. Flamingo your right heel to your seat. Okay. Sink a little bit further back and down if you can. We're gonna go into a low lunge, so your right toes are going all the way through the back of your mat. Bring your hands to the earth to land. And inhale your left leg to the sky, three-legged dog. On your exhale, knee to nose. One-legged plank, extend out, breath in. Left knee, left tricep, breath out. Inhale to lengthen. Exhale towards your right tricep. Three-legged dog, we lift up. Out breath, lands your left foot forward. Standing splits, right leg to the sky, breath in. Shiva squat, bend and tap. Option to challenge your balance. Then back to standing splits, re-extend. Okay. Shiva squat, bend to tap. Use your gaze, push down to extend. Final time here, Shiva squat, we stay. Stand into your left foot, bring your hands towards your heart. Hug in through your belly, hug in through your right heel. We're gonna slowly go to crescent lunge, so right toes take a giant step back. Push down into your feet, inhale, lift your heart and hands. And on your out breath, airplane your arms. With an inhale, reaching crescent, send your hands up. Exhale, warrior two, start to push down, peel open. And settle in. Again, check on your alignment. Maybe your left glute can encourage your left knee wider, nice and stacked above your left ankle. And send your right heel a little bit further back so you can drive through your right heel. Inhale, reverse left hand to the sky. Good. Exhale, side angle, lean forward with intention. So try to maintain this extension to your left side body. And then maybe untuck your tail, keep the length, then roll open. And press to your feet. Send your right hand overhead when you're ready. And plug your shoulder and push down through your right palm actively. Push through your feet. And ujjayi breath as you roll your left ribcage. Open, and your right shoulder back. Circle sweep to your wide-legged forward fold. Right hand leads the way, all 10 toes turn. Take a couple of breaths. You can also choose to bend a little side to side for your last breath or two. There's twisting if you want to twist. Or anything else. There's many other variations you could be in. And when you're ready, you'll find a halfway lift. We're going to turn to the right, low lunge to the top of our mats. Your right foot is your base. Pull yourself to chair pose, long through your spine through transition. Inhale to lift your heart and hands. Exhale, airplane your arms. On your inhale, it's chair pose. Exhale, hands to heart. Weight to your right foot. Flamingo your left heel to your seat. Slow motion, we're going to a low lunge. You're gonna send your left leg back. Then your left toes and your hands to the earth at the same time. Okay, this time step into a high plank pose rather than downward facing dog. Inhale, shift forward. Vinyasa or down dog, exhale through. We'll meet in a child's pose. We'll allow your knees to sink to the earth. Hips settle to your heels and then take three breaths. After your third breath or so, we'll rise up to a tabletop pose. We're gonna take like one more kind of big layer that we're gonna combine what we've been working with some new elements. Continue to customize as much as you want to, yeah? Just starting from our tabletop pose. Inhale to your cow, lift your heart and tail. And exhale to your cat spine, round out. Feel your sternum pull through the back of your heart. Then nice and neutral, tuck your toes. When you're ready, downward dog, send your hips up and back. And then your inhale floats your right leg to the sky. Exhale, bend your knee and open your hip. Stay your wild thing, maybe step your right toes behind you. And you turn your heart open, and kind of like you're moving through a side plank, reach your right hand up and over. Use your core, use your left obliques like side plank again. Right leg finds the sky, three-legged dog. Bring your knee into your nose, shift it forward. One-legged plank, inhale, lengthen back. Exhale, right knee, right tricep. Inhale, one-legged plank. Exhale to your left tricep. Three-legged dog, right leg to right. And step your right foot forward to the top. Standing splits, your inhale lifts your left leg to the sky. Exhale, Shiva squat one time and we stay. Push through your right foot, lift your heart, hands by heart center. Hug your left heel to your seat. We're gonna expand to airplane pose this time. So push down, begin to fly. Extend length through every limb. Give yourself a breath to be here. Slowly find crescent lunge. Okay, inhale, lengthen up. Exhale, airplane arms. Reaching crescent, breath in to extend. On your breath out, bring your hands to the earth. Inhale, twist your right hand to the sky. Out breath, turn all 10 toes to the right. So you're gonna bring your left palm to the ground like a side plank. Turn your toes to the long edge of your mat, so toes to the right. You can scoot your right foot back if you need to. Roll your right shoulder back. This is our horizon lunge, so with an inhale, sink down, reach towards the back of your mat. Exhale, lift up, reach over like a rainbow. And two more here, inhale, open. And exhale, lift and reach. One more time, inhale, sink down. Exhale, up and over, wide-legged forward fold. All 10 toes, you're gonna turn to the long edge of your mat. And then dive through your center. Take a deep breath through your nose. Maybe an open mouth, exhale, release. Lift halfway with your inhale. Low lunge to the left as you exhale, turn all 10 toes around. Weight is in your left foot. Chair pose, find your seat. And inhale, lift your heart and hands. Exhale, airplane arms. Rise all the way to stand, big breath in. Right, hands to heart, breath out. Inhale to reach tall. And exhale, forward fold. Halfway lift, lengthen. Vinyasa or down dog. So you step back or flow back this time. If you wanted to add something in, you could add in extra push-ups. But try to keep the integrity of your breath, the alignment of your body. We'll take second side of this layer and then we'll be on the back body. So deep breath in through your nose. And open mouth, exhale, let it go. Inhale your left leg to the ceiling. Exhale, bend your knee, open your hip. Perhaps you flip over to your wild thing. Left toes land lightly behind you. Spin your chest open to the sky. Reach your left hand out. Three-legged dog from your core. pull the weight up and back out of your right wrist. And inhale to extend. Exhale, knee to nose. One legged plank, press back. To your left shoulder, exhale. Inhale, one legged plank. Exhale to your right tricep. Three legged dog, we lift together. Left foot to the top of your mat, nice and light, land it forward. Standing splits, offer your right leg to the sky, big breath in. One time, Shiva squat, breath out. Hands find your heart center and feel your balance. Maybe get low first. Push through your left foot to pull in through your tummy so you're compromising the low back. Airplane pose, begin to fly out. And feel your breath here. Contract through your right obliques, maybe a micro bend through your left knee. Crescent lunge with care, step back really light. Now that's an inhale, lift up high. Airplane arms, breath out. Reaching crescent, deep breath in. Hands to your mat on your exhale. Twist your left into the sky with your in breath. Plant your right hand to the earth, horizon lunge, all 10 toes to the left. Think like a sideways pigeon as you lift your hips and lean open. Inhale, maybe dip and reach back. Exhale, lift up and over. Two more here, just opening your hips a little bit more. And exhale, up and over. Last one here, inhale, sink. Exhale, lift up. Turn all 10 toes to the right, to the right, to the right until you're in your wide-legged forward fold. Halfway lift, breath in. To your right, low lunge to the top of your mat, breath out. Chair pose, your left foot steps forward. Hips go low, lift your heart and hands up high. Exhale, airplane arms. Rise all the way to stand, big breath in. Hands to heart, breath out. And inhale, reach your fingers tall. Exhale, fold to the earth. One last halfway lift, lean into it. And then bend your knees and have a seat all the way down. And from here, and just plant through your feet. If you want a little sip of water or anything before you lower down, feel free to take that. Or reach up high with an inhale. And then use your core to slowly bring you all the way to the earth with your exhale. Try to keep your feet planted as you go. Belly pulls in. And take a full body stretch once you meet your mat. You'll bring your knees into your chest. Hands to your shins, just let your knees fall wide to a modified happy baby. Heavy through your head, heavy through your shoulders and hips again. Feel the connection between your body and the earth. Maybe take a deeper happy baby, so hands to ankles or feet. You can rock from side to side or extend the leg. Sometimes it feels nice to take a hybrid between happy baby and a little Supta Baddha, right? Butterfly legs. Bring the soles of your feet together. Encourage your knees wide. From here, release your knees to your chest. Start to send your legs up to the sky. Especially if you're at home, it might be nice to send your legs up to a wall. Okay, just for a gentle inversion, if you want to, you can lift your hips into shoulder stand or plow. And then just find a couple rounds of breath here. Gaze neutral. Breath flowing through the back of your body. When you're ready to roll out, use your core. Gently roll out, let your knees fall into your heart. And then really slowly let your knees tip to the left, gentle twist. Take two more breaths. The simple switch will bring you to second side, one leg at a time through center. And then legs go all the way over to the right. Gaze maybe to the left. And just breathe. You're ready, bring yourself back to center. No rush, just take your time in your transition. Land your feet to the earth. Let the soles of your feet come together, your knees fall wide. And maybe you place one hand to your belly and one hand to your heart. Then breathe into your body. Feel your hands create contact with your breath rhythm. As you feel your inhale and your exhale move through. Maybe feel what other sensations are present. Maybe pausing in a moment of gratitude for your body, your breath, your health, and the time that you have to be on your yoga mat, cultivating deeper connection. Maybe allow yourself to get a little bit heavier here. Maybe even scoot your legs a little bit further away into a longer diamond shape. And as you stretch your breath in both directions, just see if there's anything else that you need. If you want to stay here or if you're ready for your Shavasana. So maybe you allow your legs just to go out long. If you want to hug your knees into your chest for a final squeeze, you can. Hands go wherever is comfortable. As you find that really cozy landing spot, let your breath maybe start to release back to its natural rhythm for a moment. If it would feel good to take one final clearing breath, draw in a nice deep inhale. And then open mouth, exhale, let it go. Allow your breath to start to deepen again. And as you feel your breath move all throughout your body, filling those new spaces that you created. Every exhale be that invitation, opportunity to let go again, any lingering tension or tightness, any heaviness on your heart or mind. If you're comfortable as you are, feel free just to stay. Offer yourself extra time to relax and reset. Then we start to bring some movement into your body. Fingers, toes, hands, and feet. Maybe a big breath in for a full body stretch. As you exhale, you can either bring your hands to your heart right away. Start to make your way up to a comfortable seat. Deciding where you'd like to close your practice. As you bring your hands to your heart, awareness turned inward, may take this final moment to pause. Recognize the time, the energy, the intention that you offered your practice. And we acknowledge the gift of having a healthy and able body. And then deep gratitude of all that we are, who we are. Let's take a big breath in. And open mouth, exhale, release. May yoga offer us a path to compassion. And may your practice serve as your teacher, lead you in living more authentically and loving more deeply each and every day. Thank you so much, and namaste. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope that this flow has offered you some grounding and some connection to your body. I will be posting this later, and I'm going to post the playlist that I was listening to while moving to this. So if you want to turn that on at the same time, you can. Once again, thank you so much.